ago was Mark Dugdale. We talked prior to that event that that was a critical crossroad for his career. He hasn't been competing very long, but I think a lot of us felt that it was going to really dictate the direction of his career, and he ended up answering the call. He finished a very impressive second place at the Ironman. He took last week off, did not go to Sacramento. What are your thoughts on how Mark looks tonight?
Mark looks absolutely fantastic. I like to refer to him as the consummate professional, Dan. You can see attention to detail is very much in Mark's repertoire. But you can see the tan, the preparation, the color, the trunks. You know, everything is dead on the money and a very, very good look. The only problem Mark has is he needs a little bit more muscle in the back. He's a little up and down. And, again, I'm being hard on him, but I'm comparing him to this crew. And, again, he falls into that same category as the Ronnie Rockles and David Henrys. And some of those guys. Nothing wrong with him, Dan. He's just giving up a lot of muscle and a lot of height to some of the bigger guys. So I'd like to see Mark contend if he can get himself down just a couple of pounds. I think he's just over that 210 mark, maybe in that Europa Pro Show in that under 210 class.
For you fans of Mark Dugdale, you can, of course, celebrate the fact that Mark is qualified for the 2007 Olympia, his very first Olympia qualification. So you'll see him in Las Vegas this September.
You can see what I'm talking about right there, Dan. Again, a back lat spread from Mark Dugdale. Excuse me. A little bit up and down. Like I say, we're nitpicking. But again, this is the pros. This is the IFBB. And that's what you've got to stand next to. And you've got to look good in comparison with somebody next to you. Like I say, a little bit weak in the back. Very good, very complete physique.
Not only is it the pros, but of course it is the Arnold Classic. And it's the 2007 edition of the Arnold Classic, which might just be the most hotly contested one we've ever seen. We tried to make the argument the other night on Pro Bodybuilding Weekly. Is this the most impressive non-Mr. Olympia lineup we've ever seen, Bob? And in looking at it, I'd say from the standpoint of names, it's the most impressive. The question I have for you is, based on what we've seen in these athletes, is it the most impressive field?
I think it's one of the most impressive fields I've seen. It's very deep, and again, like I said before, some very, very good bodybuilders are going to be placing down in those bottom spots, and it's a testament to how much the sport has grown and where it's at right now.